Well, the waiting is just about over. And the time has come to celebrate once again the birth of the Christ child. God, shine your light into our hearts so Christ may be born anew in us this holy night. Let us join our hearts and voices in song and celebration in this Christmas medley. In your order of service, you'll find the three songs, O Come All Ye Faithful, O Little Town of Bethlehem, and Once in Royal David City. And we can remain seated for the singing of these hymns. number 62, and we'll sing all the verses. Welcome, everybody. Welcome in friendship, welcome in faith, and welcome on this holiest of nights. It's a big night, and we got a big day tomorrow. And if there are any young people in our congregation this evening, or maybe watching tonight via YouTube, I heard from NORAD that there have been some spottings of Santa. There have already been some sightings up around North Bay. So, you know, I know there's an anthem later on this evening, and it's called Do Not Find Me Sleeping, but if you're, you know, hoping for Santa to come, I think maybe it's time to get that stocking up and see what happens overnight. Ready or not, we come filled with excitement to hear once again the ancient Christmas story of old on this holiest of nights. Open wide the crowded inns of our hearts so we may see with new eyes what happened so long ago. Open our ears so we may hear your voice in the voices of all those around us. Fill us with wonder and mystery so we may experience your loving presence with us now on this eve of Christmas. So now I'm going to all invite you to take a quiet moment. Take a few deep breaths. Forget about your to-do lists. Forget about the turkey that has to be stuffed in the morning, or maybe you've already had your dinner. Even more so now that you can relax and let go. Holy One, as we arrive here, both excited and weary after all our preparations, place your calming hand upon our souls Help us to catch our holy breaths. It's a special night. It's a holy night. Let us remember the gift of love as symbolized in the Christ child. May the blessing of this holy eve open our eyes to a new way of life, a life of compassion as lived out in the life of Jesus. Restore our souls and renew a right spirit within us. Join me now in the call to worship as printed inside your order of service and as will appear on your screens at home. Welcome everybody on the holiest of nights. Welcome home. As Mary prepared herself to give birth to Jesus, let us prepare ourselves to welcome new birth and new possibilities. As a child prepares to open that special gift on Christmas morning,
let us prepare our hearts to receive once more the wonder of God's amazing love that came down that first Christmas.
I'd like to say a special hello to Susan and John Bacelia. They're watching in the comfort of their homes this evening with their families. Hi to Susan and John and to Linda and Murray Arnold. They're down in London, Ontario, tuning in, beaming in thanks to technology. Let us stand for our opening hymn, Joy to the World, number 59. Join me now in the Christmas Eve prayer as printed inside your order of service. Let's pray together. God of star and manger, we give you thanks for the blessings in our lives, even in this year of COVID and uncertainty. Open our eyes and hearts to your presence in our world. Forgive our obsession with stuff and our too narrow vision. Open us to your grace. We have struggled to love one another as you have loved us. This COVID virus has not only taken too many lives, but it is also gobbling up friendships and leaving families divided. May we treat each other with kindness even if we don't agree with one another. Heal our divided hearts. Bring us back around our tables once more, and help us to light a candle to dispel the darkness. And may Christ be born anew this night in our own actions of hope and love. Amen. Well, our journey to Bethlehem wraps up here tonight on this eve of Christmas. And for the last four Sundays, we have been lighting the candles of hope, peace, joy, and love, the four promises offered to us by God. And all of these promises manifest in one candle that we are going to light tonight, the Christ candle. And I'm going to call upon our candle lighter tonight, Kiara Brisebois, and she's Gordon Fran's granddaughter. And as she lights the Christ candle this evening, we need to remember that Jesus is the light of the world, a light that breaks through our darkness and our brokenness. And may this flame remind us of God's constant presence and unwavering care tonight and in the new year ahead. Come to us, Jesus, be born anew in us this night, in our hearts, in our minds, and in our lives. Let our hearts glow with the light that was in him, so we can become like candles through which his light shines still. Thank you, Kier. Kier is home from university. It's nice to be home, isn't it? A little home cooking, a little sleeping in a little bit. It's all good. I know they're glad to have you home. So it's nice to have you back here as well. Kiara was actually on the search team, and she was one of the young people that was responsible for being here, I guess. I don't know if that's good or bad, but that's all right. They're not throwing eggs at you, so that's good. So now we're going to have our Christmas anthem by our mixed chorus. As you can see, our choir is small in numbers because we are doing our best to stay ahead of this virus and the numbers that are charging upwards. I think we're close to 10,000 in the province this day, and it's like, but we're still here. Small in numbers, but I know there are people watching from home in the safety and comfort of their home, so we're glad to have everybody with us tonight. Our Christmas anthem, Do Not Find Me Sleep.
Do not find me sleeping.
are going to experience once again the Christmas story of long, long ago. Now, our Christmas hymns and our choir selections will be interspersed within the story, and they will be sung while we remain seated. Now, they're not going to be announced, so you're going to have to stay awake. Do not find you sleeping. And the hymn numbers, of course, are printed here in your order of service as well. And our first scripture reading will be read by Kevin Holly, and he will start things off for us tonight. Kevin?
As mentioned, our first reading comes from John 1, and it's verses 1 to 9. The Word became flesh. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world.
I'm reading from Luke chapter 3, verses 15 to 18. As the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, "I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand to clear his threshing floor and to gather the wheat into his granary, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire." So, with many other exhortations, he proclaimed the good news to the people.
Luke 1, 26-38, the birth of Jesus foretold. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and he said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her.
Taken from the second chapter of Luke, beginning at verse 1 through 7. And this is the news we've all been waiting to hear. It's the birth of Jesus. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Mm-hmm. The fifth discussion here tonight, it talks about the angels and the shepherds, and it sounds to me like the shepherds were having a quiet evening with their flocks at night, and then they had a visitor. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said unto them, "Do not be afraid, for I'm bringing you good news of great joy to all the people. To you is born in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This is a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth, lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God and saying, "Glory be to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors."
From Luke chapter 2, verses 15 to 20. After the shepherds heard about the infant baby, they started out in search of this news of great joy. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt his worth. A thrill of hope the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. Oh, night divine, oh, night when Christ was born. Oh, night divine, oh, night divine. Truly he taught us to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Oh, then ever praise.
For the rest of the night. That was beautiful. Oh, Holy Night is a staple in Christmas Eve service, so that was... I don't know if you know this or not, but Doug Hicks is the father of our country star, Tim Hicks. Did you know that? Yeah? You know that? I said to Doug, I said, you know, where does Tim, you know, get his voice? And Doug told me tonight that in an interview, Tim said he didn't know. Poor old dad doesn't get any credit at all. So we're gonna give you some credit tonight. That was beautiful, and Chuck, your accompaniment on the guitar was lovely as well. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, our light and our wisdom. Amen. Tonight, as we approach the bewitching hour of midnight on Christmas Eve, there is a powerful magnetic force drawing people from all around the world to churches just like Trinity United Church. Sadly, because of our rapidly escalating COVID numbers, the number of people who can actually come home for Christmas is limited. We are leaning into the hope that next year every single pew will be filled. Amen? We're living into that hope. So tonight we are drawn to the mystery and the expectancy of this silent holy night. We come to see the candles that gently push back the darkness. And we come to listen to the calm, hushed silence, to hear our ancient story once again. Why are you here this evening? Or why have you taken time out of your busy preparations to be with us in the comfort of your home? Sitting on chairs and sofas, all of us united in the spirit which is Christmas. I know some of you are here because you want to be here. And some of you are here because you have lost the faith that you had as a child. And oh, how you long that God could be alive in your heart again. Others may be here because you want to hear a word of hope. You want to hear a word of reassurance, and yes, we're going to get through another round of surging COVID cases again. Maybe that magnetic force that's drawing you here tonight is because you and your partner have hit a rough patch in your marriage or in your relationship. And if God is the source of all love, then you want to have God help you to begin to love again. And yet, others are here tonight, or maybe tuning in today, because you're like Scrooge. You're here tonight because somebody dragged you here, kicking and screaming. Bah humbug. I can see a few smiles there. You don't have to put your hands up. Just blink your eyes like this. But get this. Even those of you who have come kicking and screaming tonight, maybe there's something deep down inside of you that needs to be filled as well. Maybe you need a renewed sense of purpose, and maybe you need to have your heart restored as well. Finally, others are here tonight because why? Because it's Christmas Eve. And what do you do on Christmas Eve? You come home on Christmas Eve. For years and years, you've been coming to church on Christmas Eve because you know this is where you need to be. Right, Maurice? Maurice almost missed Christmas Eve, but no, he's here. And how many years would have been 20 odd, eh? You're here because you know that there's something inside of you that's connected to that divine light that's inside each and every one of us. You know, much has been written about the sentimentality of this holy season and of the various ways in which this Christmas season has been abused and even misunderstood. Writer John Vandeleur says, "Even the call to put Christ back in Christmas misses the point. Christmas, my friends, is not just about the birth of a baby, no matter how divine. It's about how this baby grew up to be a man who would be for us, as writer Richard Rohr says, a model for what it means to live from here, to live from our hearts. Jesus is a model for how to live from our hearts. You see, as you've heard me say before, Jesus didn't come to start up a church. Jesus came to start a movement of love and compassion. Jesus' message and Jesus' mission was never about himself. He never ever said, come worship me. He said, come follow me. Follow me. Follow me into a world where everybody is welcome at the table of life. Where love is love. Where everybody is a somebody and nobody is excluded. Nobody is excluded because of income or abilities or race or color or sexual orientation. The good news on this Christmas Eve, my friend, is whatever reason you're here tonight, God is with us all. In the very messiness of life, our messed up marriages, our messed up families, our messed up culture, God is still Emmanuel, meaning God is still with us in the good, the bad, and the ugly. The good news this Christmas is the Spirit of God, the Spirit of love, can be born anew in the mangers of our hearts. And this Spirit of love can give us that inner strength, the courage, and the hope to live our lives wholeheartedly and fully in all the messiness and all the despair that this world has to dish out to us. The message of Christmas doesn't say that God will protect us from the messiness of life. And goodness knows there's a lot of messiness. But God does promise to go through the messiness with us. We don't have to go it alone. The Spirit of love can provide a light that darkness cannot overcome. So perhaps as we get set to leave tonight, we can find room and we can feel again that love starting to bubble up again in the mangers of our hearts. Our world is desperate for that love right now, for that hope and for that peace and for that joy. And maybe, just maybe, that this magnetic force is drawing all of us closer to the kind of world that Jesus envisioned. What kind of world was that? It was a world that is wrapped in infinite love. May the blessings of love's pure light shine upon us, and the wonder of our story of love fill all our hearts. Amen. What a gift we have been given, the Christ child born into the world as love itself. As you know, this is a season of receiving and giving gifts. Our Christmas offering will now be received. in our Christmas offering prayer as printed inside your order of service. Christmas God, on this most sacred and holy night, through these gifts, we give thanks for the birth, the life, and the spiritual teachings of Jesus. Bless them and use them. Bless us too, so we can help spread Christ's message of peace and goodwill into all the dark corners of our world. Amen. Now I would like to invite any young people that we may have in the congregation, or young at heart, because whose birthday is it that we're celebrating? Exactly. So we have something special for our young people. We have a COVID-friendly, a little, thank you, where's Nancy? Nancy Waxel made these cupcakes with a candle. So all, any young person would like to come down, and young of heart, please come, and we're going to sing Happy Birthday to Jesus. Okay? Holy night. Yes. And Judy is going to dim the lights. Judy's going to dim the lights. Number 67. I'd like to take this opportunity to wish every one of you a blessed and joyous Christmas. And I am going to invite you to say Merry Christmas, to turn around and say Merry Christmas to your neighbor and your friend, because I don't want anybody sort of gathering as we're leaving, because we're going to go row by row, and we're going to be as COVID friendly as possible. So turn around and say Merry Christmas to your friends. Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas! We even got a couple of kisses up there in the balcony. Ho, ho, ho! Too bad we don't have a camera up there. That's wonderful. It's so nice to have you out. Even though it's a small crowd, we had a wonderful evening here. And we wish you a wonderful Christmas season ahead. And what we will do after Kianga has her postlude, we will get up and we will just go row by row and just immediately exit the building. And if you absolutely have to have your Christmas hug, just put your hand over your heart and just say Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and we'll see you in 2022. So Merry Christmas, everybody. Merry Christmas.